I'm Sunil Philip, partner at the design-based design collective collaborative PSP, which stands for Pradhan Sethi Philip. And the other partners in the firm are Ajay Sethi and Prerna Pradhan. And 11 years ago, PSP was formed, headquartered out of Chennai. The reason why we call ourselves a collaborative or compulsive collaborators are because we believe that no single idea is good enough unless it's tested. So very often we have design projects where we have a driver for the project, but there are also navigators. This project is a city home for a family of four over three generations. A well-traveled family, but the brief was actually just a functional brief like most of the briefs that you would get for a project. So we had to dwell further, and typically you need to do that. So we spent a fair amount of time with the client trying to understand where they came from. The site was a rectangular site in a slightly crowded locality, and we had a road in the front, which is a fairly crowded road. You had houses which were in very close proximity of the property, and the orient of the property was north-south on the linear direction, on the longer direction, and east-west on the shorter direction. Okay, so because of the proximity of these buildings and everything being crowded, so we actually worked out a insular kind of environment. So the house is more inward looking. The other elements of the property was that we had a few trees. There was a beautiful plumeria tree in the front. We had a neem tree on one side, and we had some other trees which were largely onto the western side of the property. So what we did was that we took some clues from how these things were sitting around here. We built a little court to go around this, and we brought the house forward. There was not much of a setback onto this, so we actually set the house back a little bit, pulled it back here, and we had a configuration which worked quite much like this. So which meant that we could have the garden space which was here and moving onto the side of the property. We also worked out these steps onto the front, which were these wide garden kind of steps which you could actually sit on and spend time onto the front of the house. Okay. Climatically, the house being oriented on the north-south axis, what happened was that much of the radiation actually comes in from the south. So we used a double wall, a thickened double wall onto the south and the western face. So insulating these two directions, which also meant that the openings that actually came in here were set in openings. We had the courtyard which was coming out of having this tree over here, which worked well from making this like a coat kind of a feel. And the larger openings were oriented larger to the front of the house. So we had these large openings onto the living and the dining spaces, and the smaller openings onto the south and western side. So which also meant that we also had these light coats which were in the front here, and we had this staircase coat which was in this location, which had the steps going up here. Both these worked as light coats. So there's a fair amount of light actually which comes in from these two locations and from directions which are from here and here and from here and here. So from the street, we had this linear axis which was developed, okay? And we had the other spaces. The staircase going up here, and you have the kitchen onto the back here, and then you have one of the other spaces here. So predominantly what was happening because of this was that you had this central spine which ran across with all the other spaces sitting around it relating to each other. So it is almost like a street light kind of a thing with various points of references which are coming in, where the house was reacting like a street with various functions opening onto it. The front of the building uses copper, which currently envelops the front of the house onto one side and slips into the foyer of the house also. The beauty about copper is that in a period of time, it's going to tarnish, it's going to turn into something a little bit more patchier than this, and over the next 10-15 years, it's going to land up looking like this. Sectionally, we see this wall, which actually runs across all three levels, which runs along the spine of the building, which is a concrete surface similar to this, and the accents onto the wall are with brass accents. So this is largely also because constructionally concrete cannot be even troubled cast for more than a meter length. So this is to break the joints and also provide articulation which comes onto the surface. Sectionally, you can also see the light coat which comes onto the front of the building. We have this beautiful chandelier which comes down, which is like a capsule, glass capsule chandelier, which throws very nice light onto the concrete surfaces and the copper which is onto the other side of the building. The other surfaces that we've actually looked at using tactile material is where we've used cotton steel. This is one of the screens that is within the house. It actually is a screen between the master toilet and a little garden space which is there onto the outside. So it's a twin layered screen. There are two layers of cotton steel. So it's punctured in some parts and some parts are opaque. And it allows in beautiful filtered light into the spaces which are within. This is another detail of how the compound wall works. Being an inward facing house, we had to actually do some amount of protection which was happening from this road in the front, which is very busy. There's a lot of traffic, fair amount of dust being kicked up. So there's been a certain treatment which is actually used onto the wall, which is like hacked granite kind of surfaces, hand-traveled concrete finishes, louvers which go onto the front, and there is a metal portal which runs along the entire stretch, which has got lighting features which lights the main wall onto the front. See, largely the house is a neutral palette, so the horizontal surfaces, which is the ceiling and the floor, is predominantly white, and the walls are textured, meaning a fair amount of the walls have got finishes like hand-traveled concrete. There is a lot of surfaces which are hand-chiseled marble surfaces. There are installations which go onto the walls in this land. But we've kept the ceiling as clean as possible and the floor as clean as possible. So the floor is actually white marble predominantly across the house. Some parts of the house we've actually used wood for the thing. Stylistically, the house is a modernist house, but the furniture is predominantly mid-century Western. So overall, this actually makes the house very alive. It's almost like a living creature, and it ages with the people in the house.